Boss, I've been meaning to tell you something. Our old friend Zero hasn't been seen in public since you left the States. That was over 10 years ago now. You suspected he was responsible for the accident at your base in the Caribbean. But at that point, Zero was already bedridden. So it never felt right to me that Zero gave the order. Now that I've seen the man Emmerich was working for, I'm sure he didn't. I know that man. He was our old friend's XO. A man without a face. Not one you want to look at anyway. Skullface. He's the one who destroyed your base 9 years ago. The unit he commands, XOF, was Cypher's strike force. But he since split from Zero and used XOF to usurp control over Cypher itself. In other words, the Cypher we're hunting isn't Zero. Beyond Zero is a void that's even darker. Skullface.
Commencing platform construction. Please select a mission.
The objective is to rescue and extract a Mujahid captured by the Soviets. He's being held in the ruins of Lamar Hati Palace, as are a lot of POWs. Civilians, guerrillas, suspected guerrillas. The Soviets have turned the place into their own black site. However, we've only been asked to rescue one of the prisoners. He's known as Malak, Angel to his fellow Mujahideen. The client is none other than his father. Or rather, this was his father's dying wish.
Mission accepted. Heading to Afghanistan.
Is to rescue a prisoner being held at Lamar Hati Palace. He's known as Malak, Angel to his fellow Mujahideen.
Start by checking the target's VI on your iDroid. The Soviets captured him and took him to the ruins of the palace. His family was subsequently killed in an airstrike on his village. The Soviet scorched earth operation wiped it off the map. The client is none other than his father. Or rather, this was his father's dying wish. If you can manage to rescue other prisoners as well, each one will add a bonus to our pay. When you see them, I'm sure your conscience will tell you what to do.
Analysis complete. 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 You have arrived at your destination. Clouds approaching.
Palace, where the target is being held. There's a Soviet detention facility.
Watch out, boys! Don't shoot!
Anti-air radar? It wasn't one of the targets, but that's put a hole in their air surveillance. The chopper will be able to get in close now. You can designate a landing zone near the outpost.
Intel file obtained. Extraction arrived.
We've analyzed the intel file you discovered. Orders for their transport route. The target's been transferred. I've sent the information to your map screen. You're gonna need more information to pinpoint a location.
The map has been updated.
That's the target's predicted field of movement. We need more specific intel.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Analysis complete. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Analysis complete. Prisoner has died. Some will set shortly. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Prisoner has died.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us. He's coming too. Roger that.
Caution. Extraction failed. Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
intel on the target's whereabouts. Why don't you see what the enemy has to say? Interrogate them.
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
just have to do it by chopper. Call the chopper from your iDroid, boss. Then carry the target to it.
The map has been updated. Please select support helicopter.
Roger.
Requested.
Sımaklar var. Sımak dolu kurmayın mı? Ne? Bıçak mı var? Daha da çağla yedi. Çıma böyle boz. Kıvalı da sıkıyor. Udurek. Bağ o kasanı da mespa. Çizeye kurmayacağım. Мала санзара в опас бус.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
Mission complete, boss.
Saying that he's never heard of our client. What's more, he says his village was destroyed long before he was ever taken prisoner. Apparently it fell victim to some sort of disease, then was completely burned to the ground. Malik was out on a mission at the time, and that's the reason why he alone survived. But the question is, who hired us to find him? According to Malik, he saw strange soldiers snooping around the village when he got back. Turns out they were members of Cypher Strike Force XOF. My theory is they wanted to get their hands on Malik to question or silence him before the Soviets could get to him. Cypher was just using us to cover things up. All that crap about Malik's relative was a front to convince us to retrieve him. But an entire colony just wiped off the map. It sounds a lot like the Hamid during the Honeybee incident. All I know, boss, is there's no way in hell I'm handing Malik over to Cypher. I decided to bring him back to Mother Base instead. He's one of us now. We told the client through a cutout that the target was killed. For some reason, though, they still paid us everything we were owed. Cypher's obviously up to something, and this is probably just another preemptive cleanup operation to them. But to Malik, he lost his village, his family, everything, and he wants his revenge. In other words, he's one of us. Boss, if you got time on your hands, come spend it back at the base. The men will miss you if you're gone too long.
Welcome home, boss.
Please specify a project.
That woman doesn't talk, the boss box.
No idea. I wonder if she's even human.
What? Come on, if she isn't human, what is she? Alien? Some kind of bioroid?
I don't know. The way she moves, disappears, I wouldn't count anything out.
Give me a break. It's probably
technology. Please select a landing zone. Landing zone confirmed.
Roger.
Didi, stay.
Didi.
Fully trained and ready for action. The rest is up to you. Didi, go.
Unit function added. Development project has been...
Let me explain what D-Dog can do as your buddy. With that nose of his, he can sniff out and mark nearby enemies and prisoners. Should come in handy for infiltrating outposts. I trained him to detect mines and medicinal plants, too. When he locates something, check your map.
Weather will clear shortly. Please select a mission.
Boss, this contract comes out of Angola. That's right, Central Africa, where Emmerich claimed they were working on a weapon to surpass Metal Gear. There's been a massive oil spill from Mafinda oil field. It's flowing into the river and contaminating the water supply. An environmental NGO has asked us to stop the spill by destroying the facility. Environmental activism isn't exactly our line of work, but it's not that simple either. The group operating the oil facility and causing the spill is the rebel group UNITA. And word has it that UNITA is getting supplied with U.S. military weapons. That sounds to me like Cypher's pulling their strings. Boss, it's time to give Cypher a little surprise.
Ever since the attack on your unit 9 years ago, the name Big Boss has become known the world over.
What do you mean?
Those of your men who survived traveled far and wide. They fought throughout the world. In fact, they're part of the reason we have all these PFs now. Every one of them suffered their own phantom pain from losing you. Talking about you wherever they went helped to heal their wounds. Your actions and words, your legend, has been told on every battlefield they've set foot on. Obviously, as the tales have spread, the truth's been distorted, painted over. Big Boss sacrificed himself to show us the threat that Cypher poses. He sounded a warning, so it goes.
A warning?
Too much power destroys the hands that hold it. Apparently, you chose to be a living example of that.
I never said any of that.
The moment any truth is passed on, it starts turning into fiction. The problem is, fiction inspires people more than facts. To the world, you're now the legendary mercenary Big Boss. The lessons you've taught the PFs are the reason they're so widespread. They're the reason they've survived. And you know what they all aspire to? To one day go nuclear, just like you did, and stand up to Cypher.
Of all the stupid things you could do,
they'll never understand what you really wanted. Heroes are misunderstood. It takes a man of the same caliber to understand what drives them. Bottom line is, these guys want to be like their hero, Big Boss. And deep down, they all have their eyes on nuclear weapons. They say that a nuke is the only means of standing against Cypher. But these days, it's becoming little more than a slogan to rally the troops and survive in a cutthroat business.
Currently, there are three major PFs who've expanded into Central Africa. CFA, Rogue Coyote, and Zero Risk Security. HEC's investigations have shown there's almost no overlap between their areas of operation. It's not so much a turf war, more like they have a gentleman's agreement. If you do cross paths with them,
you probably won't have to face more than one at a time. Still, don't expect to walk in the park. The CFA, Contract Forces of Africa. These guys are a major player. Their head office is in Pretoria, South Africa. That's also where the South African Defense Force is headquartered. We think the two are closely connected.
Caution. Rain.
An HEC investigation revealed that most of the CFA's operators are former SADF soldiers. South Africa has been locked in struggles with neighboring regimes for years. That means constant action. And we know better than anyone that's the best kind of training. A company drawing its recruits from hardened military vets. You can bet they know how to handle themselves. Do not underestimate them. Within the CFA is a company of soldiers made up mainly of locally hired operators. They speak Afrikaans to communicate with personnel from the CFA. But if you notice any speaking the local language, that's them. Though hired from the local population, they were originally part of a paramilitary group, so they'll have plenty of combat experience. And unlike their days shooting junkyard rifles out of beat-up pickup trucks, the CFA now supplies them with the latest gear from the West. On top of that, they've been combat trained by the South African Army. All that adds up to a much stronger fighting force. So don't brush them off. Look at the Angola-Zaire border region. The east bank of the Muneni River, in particular. It's a microcosm of a problem that stretches all across Africa. There's a civil war going on in Angola, fought between the government MPLA and the Western-backed UNITA. Zaire is still a dictatorship under President Mobutu, but numerous uprisings have broken out in its remote regions. With all the trouble elsewhere keeping their hands full, neither government has control over their side of the border. They depend on militias and PFs, as do the rebels. Government forces, guerrillas, militants, groups of all shapes and sizes hawk whatever resources they can to hire PFs. Conflict brings PFs. PFs expand the war zone, and more conflicts erupt in a continuous chain reaction. Sounds like our kind of work. Mother Base could grow by leaps and bounds.
Please specify a project. Please specify a project. Please specify a project. Please select a mission.
target is Angola's Mfinda oil field, upstream from the landing point. A spill has covered the whole area in crude. A pipeline that crosses the Muneni River failed, and now the shore's a mess. Not to mention the villages downstream have no drinking water. The oil runs to the pipeline from that facility. Taking it out should end the leak. The client this time is an environmental NGO. Destroy the facility. Stop that leak. This may seem like straight-up philanthropy, but there's another reason we agreed to it. The Mfinda oil field was outdated. Abandoned. Then the rebel group UNITA moved in, taking it upon themselves to kickstart operations. UNITA's been rapidly modernizing its arsenal. Rumor has it someone's been selling them U.S. military hardware. Intel's analysis suggests the broker's a front company, Cyphers. Keeping tabs on UNITA could tell us who's pulling its strings. Zones as private forces, or PFs. Guys we fought alongside are dying all around the globe for no reason. No banner. But it's how they survive. The demand for PFs here in Africa is especially high. Cold War standoffs, resource exploitation, tribal clashes. What's big business for developed countries has only brought conflict here. That mess you're standing in is just the latest example.
Presence detected. The map has been updated.
It's digitalis. It's toxic, but it can also be used as medicine. You've arrived at Masa Village. It's been turned into a supply hub for UNITA. Meaning it'll be stocked with weapons and resources.
Complete.
Should be a thing or two that'll come in handy. Don't be shy. They deserve to be in better hands.
The map has been updated. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
child soldiers. Children there are abducted and trained to be soldiers. They're only taught to fight. And one day they grow up and teach the next generation the same way. With a gun in his hands, a kid is as dangerous as any adult. Only they don't know a thing about right and wrong. Boss, do not hurt any child soldiers. If you do, the mission is over.
Analysis complete.
Settlement. Now a
detected. The map has been updated.
There it is. The oil facility. To stop the leak, you need to shut down the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. The details are on your iDroid. That's one of the targets. The oil transfer pump. Shut it down.
Analysis complete. Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated. Analysis complete.